In 2012, after reviewing the evidence, the American Medical Association released a major statement. Nightlight can disrupt your sleep cycle. However, for whatever reason, not many people have since been informed about it. So, here's the basics of what you need to know. When you're exposed to a significant amount of light, specifically of the blue wavelength, your body suppresses melatonin production to make you feel more awake. Normally, this evolutionary design works pretty well. With the coming of night and day, our melatonin levels waxes and wanes, giving us our circadian rhythm. However, since the invention of artificial lights, we're being exposed to more and more light at nighttime, and these effects can be pretty big. Here's what happens when you place participants in a room with similar brightness to your average household. This is where their melatonin levels would normally be if they were sleeping in a dark room, and here's their melatonin levels in that lit room. You can see the huge suppression of melatonin. And it doesn't take too much to see these effects either. In one experiment, being on the iPad at full brightness for 2 hours was enough to suppress melatonin levels. Now, this experiment was held in a dark room. Assuming you've got the lights on at home, you'd probably get an even bigger effect. Perhaps this partly explains why some people find it harder to sleep earlier. Thankfully, there does seem to be a threshold. For example, staring at that iPad for 1 hour wasn't enough to suppress melatonin levels. Furthermore, since it's specifically the blue light that has an effect, filtering it out should also help. For example, there are free programs like f.lux which filter out significant amounts of blue light from computer screens. Even NASA plans to use blue filtered light bulbs to help their astronauts get better sleep. So, try minimizing your exposure to light at nighttime and see what effect it has on you.